Rock a dad bod, drive my Hellcat like it's NASCAR, it's NASCAR. Barbecuing in my backyard, gotta love it on my dad bod.
Welcome to the preview of the Sleeman Cup Finals, the first ever. Your host, K-Fell of the WOSHL podcast. And that's right, you can see it right there on the graphic. The Sleeman Cup could either go to the Tillsonburg Thunder or the Allura Rocks. Things get underway this weekend. Here is a look at how the game structure will break down. Game one goes April 1st, 8:30 p.m. in Allura. Well, it will be played in Fergus, however. Game two, 7:30 in Tillsonburg on Saturday. Game three goes April 8th, so next Friday, 8:30 in Fergus / Allura. We'll be hosting that game. Game four, April 9th in Tillsonburg. Game five goes April 22nd in Fergus. And game six, if necessary, 7:30 in Tillsonburg. And game seven, if necessary, April 24th in Allura. So that's how the games break down. And here's how some things went. There was some year-end awards. Yeah, most outstanding player award goes to Tom Ratchford of the Tillsonburg Thunder. And there was a co-winner as well, as you can see. Ray Robbins, the Stratford Fighting Irish, the captain of that team, got the most outstanding player award. And the goaltender awards. Best individual goals against award goes to Colin Dunn of the Allura Rock. And team's lowest goals against award goes to the Strathroy Jets. So there's the awards. And don't forget, you can get yourself a Sleeman Cup t-shirt, $25. Email the Vice President Bill Ryan or the President of the League, Jamie Petrie. They'll hook you up with those t-shirts. They have a few of them kicking around, so you can pick them up to celebrate the inaugural season of the Western Ontario Super Hockey League. Speaking of the President of the WOSHL, he joins us now to discuss the upcoming inaugural finals for the Sleeman Cup.
The President, the big dog of the Western Ontario Super Hockey League, Jamie Petrie, joining me. Jamie, this is a big weekend. It's the kickoff to the inaugural Sleeman Cup. Are you excited for it?
Yeah, very excited. Yeah, it's come a long way from 2 years ago with just a thought about this league. And, you know, we've went through getting new teams in and getting a whole league started, to COVID, to growing pains, to now we're going to someone's going to hoist that Sleeman Cup in 2-3 weeks. So yeah, very excited.
Well, it has to be exciting. Like you said, you went through a lot. You went through the COVID situation. You put this league together and it's doing pretty well. You have to be proud of your accomplishments, you and the Vice President.
Yeah, it's certainly not just my vision. It's a collective vision. And you know, you mentioned the Vice President. I'll say it by name, Bill Ryan, who's did an amazing job for us. I probably talk to him more during the day than he talks to his wife. So it's it's been a lot of help with him. And then other members of our league. You know, the one thing that's different about our league is we do work together. Do we need more hands as we grow? We do. But the beauty of our league is we work together. Everybody's got a say in, if you want to call it, put it that way.
And, you know, we talk about this being the first season, but we are talking about two teams with a history here, like storied history in this level of hockey.
Yeah, they're established teams. I mean, they really are. You know, you look at Allura, the Allura Rocks name, you know, it's been back to the early 20s. You know, they've played various different leagues, whether it's been intermediate or senior A, senior AAA. So they're the various different titles, but the Allura Rock name is well entrenched in Center Wellington. And there's some titles, you know, they won some titles in the OHA. And then when they moved to the WOA, they won titles in 05, 07, 08, 2000, and 10. So, you know, they're looking to get back now. Now they've changed some management and one, when they came into our league, they changed some management here too. Rich Wigmore took over as president. Mitch Scott took over as GM and they kind of gave a boost of energy into the Allura Rocks there, because they had a couple of down years. But you know, they got the fan base back. They did stuff off the ice. They did a wonderful job, and let's call it what it is. They were the cream of the crop for the regular season. you know, the record speaks for itself. Do I think it'll be an interesting final? 100%.
Well, it sure will be 100%. Not only do the Allura Rocks, they're entrenched in their community, but the Tillsonburg Thunder also entrenched. They are a big part of Tillsonburg, and they have some history in other leagues and coming through the ranks as well.
They do, like this age demographic, you want to call it senior or 20 plus or whatever. It's been around in Tillsonburg since, you know, the early 30s as well, 30s with different names. You know, they won multiple titles in those decades up till the 80s. The Tillsonburg Vipers actually took part in the from 2001 to 2007 in the AAA Senior A League. Then in 2008, the current regime of Bill Ryan and Michael Hawley took over. They became the Tillsonburg Thunder as is. And in the WOA, in a different league there, they won two titles in 2014, 2015. And you know, they want to have their name on the inaugural Sleeman Cup trophy. Both places did a great job. And I'm not, you know, blowing smoke here. They do it right, you know, with Bill and, Michael. They've been doing this for, you know, 20 plus years. They have a knack, they have a passion for this age demographic, and it shows.
And Jamie, we got the first game, of course, in Fergus, which will be Allura's game on April 1st, 8:30. Do you imagine that barn will be packed and loud?
Yeah, I hope so. I don't see why not. You know, we've had a weekend off, and we've gathered some momentum on social media with different platforms, including this one. Yeah, it sounds like they're ready to go, and we hope that any injuries from either team are healed up, and we get the best product we can for the finals. Which you know, it's great for those two teams, but it's also a showcase for our league. Absolutely, and we're going to use it for both.
And Jamie, as a guy that's won a couple of championships, you won a couple of Southern Cups, right? Like, what is it like going into one of these? Is it a different vibe as a player? How do you feel when you step out on the ice? Is it bigger, or do you just approach it as a game?
When people say it's just another game, I call BS. It's not, mm-hmm. You know, excuse my language, but no, it's not, it's different. You know, you get the stuff in your belly and you're thinking about it all week. That's fun. That's the great, you know, right now, am I excited to watch the final? I am, but I'd be even more excited if you know, if our hockey club was in there, but I'm excited for those guys. And to speak to Mitch and Rich and Bill and Michael, yeah, they got a little jump to their step, and they should. This is exciting. Mm-hmm. You know, all the work and the long hours and carrying the all the props to the games and putting up signs and all the phone calls and trying to get players and to the rink. This is what it's all about. At the end of the year is to try to hoist a cup. Not that it's the be all and end all, but you know, to get a banner at the end of the year, especially in an inaugural season. Yeah, it's not the same. And that's a good thing.
Well, 100%. And as you said, it's not, I can't believe I even use that cliche, because I hate it too, because even any of the championship games I played in as a kid, it wasn't the same. It doesn't matter. When the anthem's playing, you're holding your stick tighter that first ship, and then you relax.
Sure. And like I said, it's to get, you know, at our age, you know, the players, you know, a lot of them have played junior or even higher up in pro or college or university. But I don't care if you're playing beer league playoffs, a slow pitch tournament on Sunday in the finals. If you don't get a little jacked up, then I wonder if you have a pulse. So this is this is exciting, and again, I'm excited for them, and I know the towns of Allura and Tillsonburg, going by social media and all that, and some good banter, fun banter back and forth. That they're stoked.
Fantastic, Jamie. I won't take up too much of your time, but you did a heck of a job this year. You and Bill putting this league together, as you said, 2 years. This is it all coming together for the next month or so. And is there some emotion there? Is it like, I can't believe we did this, or how you feel about that?
Yeah, I've did a couple of social media last in interviews the last couple of days. And what I'll say is sometimes, you know, there's frustration. Sometimes there's growing pains. Sometimes I make mistakes like anyone. I make a lot of them. But when you're having a down day, sometimes you can take a step back. And I have been able to take a step back. And sometimes with Bill in the crowd, and you look out there and there's 400, 500, 600 people and there's signs and you read the social media posts. That's pretty neat. It's pretty neat to be part of it. Someone that has rolled up their sleeves with other people, because it's certainly been a joint effort. And to see after everything said and done that we're going to have we're going to finish a season and we're going to have a championship in the next few weeks. It's amazing. And you know, the Western Ontario Hockey League is just a small portion of what the end goal is. And the end goal is to have this age demographic under one umbrella and one umbrella working together under the same rules. You know, us all working together, you know, this is the Western Ontario Super Hockey League. We have the Eastern Ontario Super Hockey League, which is the Ottawa Cornwall way. Nova Scotia is launching a league next year, the Nova Scotia Super Hockey League. We're talking to groups in the Windsor Way. We're talking groups in the Golden Horseshoe. We believe that it's this 20 plus age group is ready to take off under the Super Hockey League umbrella. And yes, very long-winded answer, but we're excited. And do you feel a little proud? Sure. You know, because I certainly a small part of it.
And well, you're saying a small part, but you are one of the reasons this has happened. So congratulations on this league's first year, even though there were some bumps, some big ones. There was a couple of pandemic there situations with that, but you got through it and you got through it stronger than ever. Congrats to you, Bill, and everyone else who put the league together.
Yep. I'll let Bill know that too. And like I said, it's, you know, I've said this too before, you go, was this the right time to do it? You know, in a pandemic and so on and so forth. But I firmly believe my answer has been very consistent. If we can pull this off in a pandemic and be successful, what are we going to do when it's normal? Sky's the limit. And I firmly believe that. The teams that we have, the five teams, are only going to get better. We're only going to work more. We are going to add three teams next year. So we will have eight going into season two. And that's healthy growth. Again, going back to the model of quality versus quantity. So, I've probably taken, I've answered too long of questions, but and hope you can tell we're excited. I speak for probably the masses of our league is we're excited and we're proud of what we've did in the first year.
And as I've told you before, long questions make my job easier. So thank you so much, Jamie.
Glad I could help.
Have yourself a great week, Mr. Petrie. Enjoy the games this weekend, and we will, of course, have you on to wrap up the season at the end of it all.
Thanks, bud. We'll talk to you soon.
So there it is. There's the words from the president himself, Jamie Petrie, about how the leagues went this upcoming finals, which kicks off Friday night in Allura. Looking forward to it. And we, of course, will have highlights for you next week. We'll have some in-game comments from players from either the Rocks or the Thunder. Looking forward to it. Again, a big thank you to Jamie Mines, who is the man, the myth, the legend behind our theme song, Dad Bods. His music is available, as you know, everywhere you can get it. Alrighty, let's end this video with a cool little finals preview video to get you jacked up and ready to go as the Allura Rocks host the Tillsonburg Thunder this Friday night. Enjoy the games. We're back with you next week.
Hello out there. We're on the air. It's hockey night tonight.
Stop the rock. Stop the rock. Stop the rock. Stop the rock. Can't stop the rock. You can't stop the rock. Stop the rock. Stop the rock. Stop the rock. Can't stop the rock.
black and yellow. Yeah, uh-huh, you know what it is. Everything I do, I do it big. Yeah, uh-huh, screaming ass nuts. When I pulled off the lot,